This is my ultrasonic cleaner. Ultrasonic cleaner is a tool where you put some kind of cleaning solution, drop in the items that you want to clean, and turn on the power and let the ultrasound do the cleaning for you. They can be used to, for example, clean PCBs, parts of pew-pew devices, or engine parts. This cleaner originally had a timer ranging from maybe 1 minute to 8 minutes. Depending on cleaning solution and contamination that is being cleaned, that might be sufficient. I like to use cleaning solutions that are 5 things. Not too strong, cheap, available locally, cheap, and safe to use. When cleaning old tools picked up from garage sales or eBay, there's often need for a longer cleaning session than just 8 minutes. Luckily, I managed to improve this cleaner by taking out the old timer and making a new one using PCBs from the sponsor of this video, PCBway.com. PCBway.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who offers PCBs starting from just $5 plus shipping for 10 two-layer 100x100mm PCBs. They are a great PCB manufacturer for all your prototyping and low-volume production needs. If you need something else than just usual two-layer boards with usual green solder mask, head over to PCBway.com, check their capabilities, and check out all the different options you have during the ordering process. When I took apart my ultrasonic cleaner and took out the timer board, I was pleased to see how simple the communication between it and the power PCB is. There is a connector with 4 pins, which are constant 5 volts, ground, and 2 GPIO pins that are high when ultrasonic or heat is on. After seeing that, I was sure I would manage to design my own controller or timer board. To make my own board as plug and play as possible, I made sure to copy the board dimensions as closely as I can, including the mounting holes. I placed buttons, LEDs, and the main connector to exactly same positions where they were in original PCB. Then it was time to choose what kind of display I'd use. I noticed that 128x32 OLED display fits in the same space as original LED display. Now all the interfacing parts were selected and placed on the board at correct positions. Controlling the I2C display, couple of outputs and 5 buttons is easy task for just about any microcontroller. There's no need for a huge amount of processing power or fancy peripherals, so I went with something that I already had at hand, ATmega328P. The board is easily replaced in this ultrasonic cleaner, but it's kinda tricky place to film. The cleaner comes apart after taking out the screws from the bottom and then the PCB is held in place with a couple of screws. It's just about as simple process as it could be. But there's mains powered PCB inside. Even when power is disconnected, capacitors can make it dangerous. Now I have the new controller connected and this cleaner is back in action. There is a heating element in this unit, but it isn't powerful enough. In my opinion, I haven't used it after trying it during first few times. Since then I've used warm water from the tap or heated the water with a kettle. That's why I haven't implemented heating and temperature monitoring in this firmware. The firmware has simple features. 2 buttons change the timer by 10 seconds, 2 change it by 1 minute, and center button starts or stops the ultrasonic cleaning and the timer. Cleaning stops when the timer reaches 0. For the testing period, I'm happy to have a working timer that can be adjusted the way I want. With the original 8-minute timer, I often needed to run it twice or 3 times. Now I can set the timer to 20 minutes and I don't need to interact with the cleaner during the cleaning session just to restart it. Currently, this is in proof of concept state. As the spring goes by and turns into summer, I will test this cleaner and take notes if I find ideas for improvements or modifications. I will refine the firmware in summer when I probably have some experience actually using this in the garage. Even though this project will be in passive testing phase, there will be other videos almost every week. So, like and subscribe. Thanks. Bye.